As you can see, Colin is a little bit taken aback, I hope.
Who wants to get off?
Right, yeah. I've just got a little speech that I'd like to read to you. It's about Colin's experiences and stuff.
Everybody get a seat.
A lot of it's just advice on retiring because I'm not so far off this end, but help yourself. So, Colin is retiring today. It was his birthday a couple of days ago, but truly of Colin, he decided that he'd want to work a couple more days just to keep his monetary flow going until he gets his pension. Colin started at Brent Lawton and Sons on the 2nd of December 1991. That's almost 24 years ago. If he'd have stayed for just one more year, he would have had a lovely gold watch, I'm sure. We're lucky. As you can tell, and people who know him, Colin is a very shy and reserved and a quiet guy. He comes to work, carries out his duties to the best of his ability. He goes home. What more could a company ask for? But it causes no trouble. But I need to just advise him on a few things. For a start off, Colin, retirement isn't quite as good as you think it is. But for a start off, you're not going to get any days off. And never mind drinking, you'll be drinking coffee and smoking in your own time. So that's something you've got to be aware of. Colin is retiring today, as I've said. But if you just close your eyes for a moment and think about it, he's been retiring for the last 3 or 4 months. You just ask Graham and Finlay and Mabu. He's sort of like been winding down for the last few months. There've been many changes over the past 24 years for Colin and for the company, and obviously things have been difficult at times and things have been good. But one thing that hasn't changed, it is Colin. He's a well-liked, well-respected guy, and basically he's a thoroughly good guy also. He's a gentleman, really, he's Colin. There aren't many of us left, there's only really me and Colin left. He loves his holidays, Colin. He usually has 2 or 3 abroad. But one thing he always does when he's been on holiday, he comes back and his batteries are recharged and he's really getting ready to tear into the job. And he always does so. And then after 3 months, he's knackered again and he has to have another holiday. There's one thing that retirement means though, Colin, is it means for a start that you can spend more time at the doctors. That's probably a good place to be. And they say that you really know about retirement is when you get that nice steak and you dig your teeth into it, you leave your teeth in it. As you pull your head back, your teeth are still there. Now this is... Not a lot of people know this. Well, Robert knows it, but not a lot of people know this. But between me and Colin, we've got 100 years of textile experience. Colin's got 70 of them. There's only one person I know who's got more than Colin, and that's Robert Hurst. He's got 80 years experience. Talking of experience, add to those experiences the skill and the knowledge over that period of time that's been built up. This is one thing that is happening to textiles, and it's going to be lost to the industry, people like Colin, who are leaving the industry with lots of skill, knowledge and experience.